It was very shortly after Pig summoned Duff that Duff's cousin, Falcon MacCallister, rode into Chugwater and answered to Duff's call for help. Falcon realized at once that something unusual was happening because it was mid-morning and First Street, a street that should have been busy with commerce, was nearly deserted. He did see people, but they were standing behind the corners of buildings, or looking cautiously through doors and windows at the few people who were on the street. One, he noticed, was Duff. Duff was standing alone, facing three men who were fanned out across the street in front of him. The man in the middle had a beautiful young woman in front of him, and he was holding a gun to her head. Falcon didn't know any of the three men, but he did recognize the young woman. It was Megan Parker, the young woman who owned a dress shop and was a one-quarter partner in Duff's ranch. Whether that partnership would ever become anything more, Falcon didn't know, but he was pretty sure it would. That is, he was sure it would if this situation could be resolved successfully. Falcon dismounted, then walked on up the street, staying on the boardwalk very close to the building fronts. Because of his caution, no one noticed him until he'd drawn even with Duff. Not until then did he walk out into the street to stand alongside his cousin.
Hello, Duff. How soon do you want to get started?
Good day to you, Falcon. I thought we might get underway on Saturday. That would put us in Cheyenne by Monday the 10th.
Good idea.
Oh, Megan, you remember Falcon, don't you? He's going to help me take our cows to Texas.
You take good care of those cows, Falcon. One quarter of them are mine.
I'll take good care of them.
What the hell are you people gabbing about? Don't you understand what's going on here?
Do you mind? We'll get to you later. Right now I'm talking to my friends here.
Yeah, well, I was here first. And I'm telling you just to back off and let us finish our business.
If it's all the same to you, I think I'll just stay here.
All right. But when the shooting starts, we ain't gonna be worrying none about whether or not you are in the way.
Oh, no, that's quite all right. I quite understand.
Now, seeing as this feller sort of interrupted us, I'll say it again real plain so that you understand. I'm told you have a gold mine. So here's what we are gonna do. You are gonna show me and my friends where that gold mine is. Because if you don't, I'm gonna shoot this here woman. Do you understand that?
Oh, I know what you said, but I don't think you have thought this through.
What? What are you talking about?
Well, think about it, Mr. Emerson. That is your name, isn't it? I think I heard one of your friends call you that. If you shoot Miss Parker, you will no longer have a bargaining position.
Miss Parker? Duff MacCallister, you mean as close as we are that you can't call me by my first name?
Aye, lass, and it is for sure that I can. I just didn't want to be intimate in front of these men.
Oh, that's real sweet of you.
What in the hell is wrong with you people? Are you crazy?
Not at all. I'm just pointing out to you the conundrum you've gotten yourself in. It's rather like a dog that sticks its head through a hole in a fence, then can't pull it back out. You see, Miss Parker is valuable to you only as long as she is alive. If you kill her, she's of no value to you whatever.
Mister, I don't know what the hell you're talking about. Now, I'm going to ask you again. Are you going to lead us to the mine or what?
Nay, I don't think I will.
Duff, it looks to me like you're dealing with someone who's too ignorant to understand. It looks to me like the only solution now is for us just to kill all three of them.
I think you are right. And while I am an accomplished marksman, I'm not fast.
As Duff was speaking, he was drawing his pistol very slowly and deliberately.
So if you would be so kind as to help me out with the other two, I'll be for putting a bullet through the eye of that unpleasant gentleman with the bad teeth.
I'll be glad to help you out.
What do you think you're going to do with that gun? Don't you see that I...
Megan stood her ground in the middle of the street, looking now at the bodies of the three men who had accosted her.
Megan, be a harmed lass.
I'm all right. That was a perfectly horrid experience.
You're sure you're all right?
I'm a lot better now than I was a few minutes ago. You have no idea how bad his breath was.